Hammers, it's Tommy the Hammer. How y'all motherfuckers doing? Welcome back to Neon Trash. Tonight we're going to be checking out a Takashi Miike film called Sukiyaki Western Django. I saw this movie a couple of years back and thought it was fucking awesome, but then again, pretty much anything directed by old Takashi Miike is going to be through the fucking roof. That guy is an amazing director. If you guys peruse my channel, you know that we've covered a lot of his films right here on good old Neon Trash. So without further ado, motherfucks, I'm gonna get right into this shit. You know this routine, peep that trailer, give it a look-see when we come back. Y'all motherfuckers are gonna know my opinion on Sukiyaki Western Django.
On a distant island, these two clans split into the reds and the whites. Wage war. Their story goes a little something like this.
Not too shabby.
Hideaki Ito, Yusuke Isaya, Kaori Momoi, Yoshino Kimura, and Quentin Tarantino.
Life is all about goodbyes.
In Takashi Miike's English language masterpiece, Sukiyaki Western Django.
Back in 2007 or 2008, when I first saw this movie, I really didn't know what to make of it. All I knew at the time was that I liked it. I thought it was very original. The cinematography was captivating. I mean, the movie almost has this technicolor aspect to the way it's filmed that can't be denied. And I'm totally drawn to movies that use that visual style. The bright colors, the gritty cinematography, everything about movies filmed in that sense really speaks to me. So I knew back then that this was a movie that was interesting. Now there's some scenes with Quentin Tarantino in this movie, and they can only be summarized by saying that it's two directors, Takashi Miike and Tarantino, ultimately paying respect to one another. And I kind of call this the Tarantino effect, maybe another director sees his work or sees the movies that he releases, gets inspired, and wants to kind of, you know, do their own take on the old retro grindhouse films. The, you know, early to mid 2000s was a renaissance. It was a time period where directors were taking chances again. They were allowed to use over-the-top violence, and with the, you know, onset of DVDs and eventually Blu-rays, they could do their movies unrated. They weren't tied down to, you know, the MPAA and movie theaters and censoring their movies. It was a whole new era. It was a time period where directors could really do the movie that they themselves wanted to see. There's a lot of hallmarks to the old school spaghetti westerns in this movie, and it's kind of interesting. You've got that whole, you know, East meets West mentality, and let's face it, guys, spaghetti westerns were inspired by the samurai films back in the day, And then now, with a movie like this, it's a samurai film that's inspired by the 1970s Western films, and it all comes back around. And I feel like that's what the most interesting aspect to this movie is. With all that being said, guys, this movie's not perfect, and, you know, with a director like Takashi Miike, who's got a shit ton of films under his belt, he's not gonna have some winners all the fucking time. And, you know, if there are shortcomings to this movie, it's that it's still relatively confusing. The director himself, you know, made kind of a risky decision here with these characters and actors. He, and from what I read back in the day, insisted that the actors actually use English and broken English as their way to execute the lines in the movie. Now, that might turn some people off, and especially if you don't know what the fuck's going on, you come into this movie and you first hear the actors, you know, doing their lines, you might be like, what the fuck? These guys are terrible actors. Well, no, it's not that. The director had insisted that the, you know, actors, you know, speak English. Out of 10 stars, I could give Sukiyaki Western Django I'm leaning towards a solid even 7 out of 10.